A very good morning, student. Now, this dissection is the dissection of the back muscle in the which are the muscles which will give attachment to the upper limb, to the vertebral column. Now here you can see the muscle, that is the this is the lower border of the trapezius. This is the spine, okay, spine of the scapula, which I am feeling with that of my thumb. This is the spine. This goes and get attached to that of the upper border. These are the transverse fiber. These are the oblique lower fibers. Okay. Now, this trapezius I will remove and will show you the structure which lies deep to it. Now, from this spine as well as from this acromion process of the scapula, you can see here, this is the acromion process. These are the posterior fibers of deltoid, which are unipinnate. Here are the fibers which are multipinnate, taking origin from the lateral border of the acromion process. Okay, so after this trapezius, I will reflect the deltoid to see the nerves and vessel under cover of the deltoid. Here you can see that this is the latissimus dorsi muscle. This is the upper border of the latissimus dorsi, and here it is this strong muscle here which is seen going towards the anterior aspect of the upper end of the humerus. This is the teres major muscle. This is the teres. Now this is the medial border of the scapula is seen here. This will be the infraspinatus muscle, okay, infraspinatus muscle. Now this muscle which you are seeing getting attachment onto the, here I can feel the angle of the scapula. So this muscle will be the rhomboides major, gaining attachment onto the medial border. This, as I said, is infraspinatus. This muscle which is seen here, this is the long head of the tricep, very strong muscle. And here, this deep inside, this is the lateral head of the tricep, both covered by the lower border of the deltoid muscle. Okay, so this was just for orientation. Now what I am going to do in the next video is that cut this deltoid as well as this trapezius, latissimus dorsi, and then see the deeper structures, okay, supraspinatus and that of the infraspinatus. I will come back after a few minutes. Thank you. Welcome back, students. Now what I did in the next step is that I just reflected and gave the cut to the trapezius muscle, which was taking origin from the vertebral column up to the neck till the horizontal fibers. Since the neck and the head is not here, so I have reflected this trapezius muscle to this side. And then deep to this trapezius muscle, I found these vessels and nerve. And these vessels and nerve are the accessory nerve. You can see the nerve here. This is the accessory nerve. And then I will just lift the accessory nerve with the tip of the forceps. This is the 11th cranial nerve, okay? And this is considered to be the spinal accessory nerve. It was coming along with the blood vessels, and that is the blood vessel is transverse cervical artery. Let me see where it has gone. Yes, it is here. See this bunch of the artery and vein running along with this. This is the transverse cervical artery, vein, and the accessory nerve running on to the under surface of trapezius and to supplying it. Then this is the medial border of the scapula, right up to this medial border is right up to the root of the spine. This is the spine of the scapula. This is the upper part of the medial border of the scapula, upper part. Now this muscle which is taking right up to the this inferior angle, see these fibers, they are coming from inferior angle right up to the root of the this spine. From this medial, this is rhomboides major, and then from this spine, this is the rhomboides minor, and then from up to the superior angle, which I can feel here, this part which is taking origin, this is the levator scapulae. I have cut these vessels also just to, because I want to disarticulate this limb. This I have already told you, it is the latissimus dorsi, okay, the upper border crossing to that of the teres major muscle. This is infraspinatus, and here we can see the supraspinatus muscle. Okay, the supraspinatus above the spine, and this is the infraspinatus. What I am going to do is that now in the next step I will cut the attachment of the deltoid and reflect it downward to show you the axillary artery and the posterior circumflex, axillary nerve and posterior circumflex humeral artery. I will come back after a few minutes. Welcome back, students. Now in this dissection, what I did that I disarticulated the limb from the rest of the trunk because I wanted to dissect the deltoid muscle from posterior, lateral and anterior side. Okay, so here is the deltoid, the posterior fibers, unipinnate. These are the multipinnate fibers of the deltoid, intermediate fibers, which are taking origin from that of the acromion process. And this is the area where it is taking origin. Again, it is the unipinnate fibers taking origin from the clavicle. Okay, just cleaning remained here. I will just clean it and will show you the unipinnate fibers of deltoid coming. See these fibers. These fibers, they are coming from clavicle and going towards the insertion on deltoid tuberosity of the humerus. Okay, that is on the lateral aspect of the humerus. Just I will clean it. Okay, we'll show you the strong tendon of the deltoid. See this, here will be the strong tendon of the deltoid will be there. Let me remove some of this fat so that you can see how the three parts of anterior, posterior and intermediate, they ultimately form a single tendon. You see this, this tendon is formed here, okay, and it will be inserting onto the deltoid tuberosity. Now what I did, I deflected this, cut this very close to the origin, very close to the origin of this deltoid. See here, okay, I have just given a cut all around, okay, on lateral side as well as on the anterior. This is the head of the humerus. This is that surgical neck of the humerus is exposed here. And if we see the inner aspect of this muscle deltoid, we will see that this bunch of the nerves and vessels, that is the posterior circumflex humeral, posterior circumflex humeral, and that is the axillary nerve, they are coming from this quadrangular space, then running on to the inner aspect of this. Let me turn it and show you. They are just going here, see here, into the deltoid, dividing into many branch, continuing around the surgical neck of the humerus. This is the surgical neck of the humerus, and this, see this now, coming around the surgical neck, the blood vessels are here, they are all going around the surgical, that is posterior circumflex humeral artery, and these are the branches of axillary. I got one of the branch which goes to that of the this teres minor, okay, teres minor. And I was searching for the ganglion but could not find that pseudoganglia. See this now, this is the teres minor muscle, okay, this is that teres minor muscle which is going here, and this now branch of the nerve was going deep inside the substance of the teres minor. I think this, yes, here is that branch which is going deep to the teres minor, right? So this completes the dissection of the structures deltoid and structures under cover of the deltoid muscles. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video.